should not be neglected. They are not boilerplate. Every one of these is meaningful, and we had a bad experience for not having them in. Federal District Court. I can tell you, you do not want to be in Federal District Court. Why? Because very few attorneys can practice in Federal District Court, and it's an unbelievable headache. And they will nickel and dime you to death with the depositions and motions. You want New York law to apply. You want to be in the county where the property is located. If you have a jury trial, do you want a jury trial in Rochester, or do you want a jury trial in Bath? I can tell you, I'll take a jury trial in Bath, because every member of that jury from Steuben County is going to know just exactly how the gas companies have handled landowners. You won't have to tell them. The people in Rochester won't know. So you will have an automatic sympathetic audience in the jury in this town. No arbitration. You want a jury trial, by the way. No arbitration. Why no arbitration? If you have arbitration and you win, and your neighbor, or you lose, and your neighbor has the exact same problem in their case, and they have to do an arbitration, and they win, and you lost, you can't do anything about that. His victory is not precedent. Your loss is not precedent. But if you go to court, and you win in court, that's precedent for that kind of case, for that fact pattern, for every single lease in the county that's not in place. And if you lose, you can go to the appellate division on appeal. If you lose an arbitration, you can't appeal. You're done. And in arbitration, you usually have to pay the other side's attorney's fees, and at least the cost of the arbitration. It's not good for you. Arbitration is the worst thing you can do in oil and gas to solve your problem. Eminent domain. You want them to waive eminent domain. Because if you don't have storage clause, and you won't if you have a coalition type lease, they can, the company, when a formation is defeated of all the assets, they can use eminent domain to condemn that storage acreage, underground, for the storage of gas. They can actually condemn, even though your lease says they can't store. They can form a separate company, still run by the same board of directors, and they can condemn that storage area. So, not only do you say no storage, but you also say they waive the right of eminent domain, either them, their stockholders, their employees, their directors, their officers, their shareholders. Otherwise, they get that storage by eminent domain, which they can do, both under FERC and under case. Conditions on covenants. Interpretations to favor the landowner, these are pretty obvious. The industry in court has used their documents to say, oh, look, this is how we always do it. We don't know that. We don't want their documents saying to the court, do it our way because the industry doesn't listen. So they waive that way. Do not put a memorandum at the clerk's office. You want that lease on. Otherwise, you're going to have problems with your bank because they can't see what the terms of your lease are. They put the bank puts the full mortgage on it. They put a memorandum of mortgage. Put a full mortgage on it. Never put a memorandum of right-of-way or pipeline easement. That's illegal, but they try to do it anyway. Record your original lease. Put a good faith clause in. Force majeure. How many people here have leases and have been given a force majeure letter? Anybody? One? Two? Okay. Force majeure is a French word, and I once had a French girlfriend, and she told me that major in French also means your middle finger. So when there is a legal clause that applies force majeure to you, you can imagine what the result is to you. It's not good. What it does is it lets the company out of doing what they're supposed to do for a period of time. Now, it originally arose because of hurricanes, earthquakes, and wars. But when a company writes it in, it's strikes, difficulty getting material, difficult selling, difficult getting rights of way, difficult getting permits. You and I have to put up with that every day in our own businesses. Company doesn't get past. You know, 5-year lease, do it. So, no force majeure clauses. By the way, if a company ever says, oh, well, everybody does that, you tell them, not in Texas. The University of Texas leases and many of these hundreds of thousands of acres do not contain a force majeure clause. So that one, I see what to say about that. Inspection rights and testing, you have to have that. They should be a fiduciary. That means they treat you with ultimate good faith. It means they can't lie to you. You have to lean on the oil and gas and the proceeds. Why? Because here's what happens. Remember, when they lease it and they take possession of the surface, they own it, right? What happens if they sell it and they don't pay you, and then they file bankruptcy? You're a general unsecured creditor and you get nothing. So they've taken your gas, they've sold it, they've distributed it to their stockholders and themselves, and then they don't pay. And bankruptcy prevents them from doing that. If you've got a lien on the oil and gas and the proceeds, now you are a secured creditor. Now when bankruptcy goes, the proceeds go to you. And if the gas is someplace else but unsold, but off the property, you get it back and you get the right to sell it, just like a mortgage foreclosure. That's a very, very important. I can't stress that enough. And bankruptcy will kill you. Not terrible. Assignment liquidity, Jim's going to talk about that. I won't talk much about that. Default and forfeiture. If you don't have the right of forfeiture, you don't have a lease of protection. You've got to make them give up the lease if they don't comply with it. In New York, we lost a case on this. According to the Appellate Division said, and this is a dangerous thing. Can you turn that tape off for a moment?